Hello, everyone. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. It's opening week in the NFL, and today we have two teams who are more than ready to get the season underway. It's the Lions going up against the Browns. Now we'll go down to Ford Field for this matchup.
The Lions are back deep, ready to return to kickoff. And Sam Martin is ready to get this one underway. And the season is underway. Quarterback, number 12, Colt McCoy. First week of the NFL season is underway. A nice grab. No doubt he was going to hold on to that one.
The post route, deep down the field, going towards the goalpost. It's not called enough in this league. Nice throw by the quarterback.
McCoy is going to throw once again on this down. The pass doesn't find a mark. And with this starting unit, as usual, the attention goes to the wide receivers who so often open up the game. Second down following that incompletion. This linebacking core is the heart and soul of this defensive unit. Following that incompletion, it sets up third and 10. The Lions will look to get to the 45 to pick up a first down. To the ground. He's brought down. That's going to bring up fourth down. Trying to establish the run, but there's nothing there here at the start.
Well, they didn't pick up many yards that time, no doubt about it, but that's a bad job by the running back. He picked the wrong side to run to. Nobody was blocked on the side he went to.
A punt just like it was drawn up, and now the defense has them backed into the corner. At quarterback, at 6'6", Mike Glennon, who has a big arm. First down now in a dangerous spot here. Glennon's set. Everybody emptied out for this snap. Out of the gun. Gordon's there to catch a ball that had a lot of heat on it. Gordon's tackled down at the 15.
It is hard to make a tackle from behind out there in open space with the speed of all these guys in the NFL, but a good job that time by the defense making that tackle.
First down at the 15. Bell up the middle. That's a gain of 6.
Yeah, let's keep our eye on the defense. If they keep giving up runs like this, they're going to have to change what they're doing on the defensive side. Maybe bring another guy down in the box to stop those runs.
That's a false start.
False start. Offense.
That's second down coming up. Bell is in the backfield. Bell's taking the handoff. And it's knocked out with a big push up front to make the play.
The Browns, they run the football on second down because they want to get third and manageable. If you do that, there's many plays to choose from on the offensive side. But now you got third and long, and that list is shrunk down to just a couple plays you could call in this situation.
Catch made out to Riley Cooper.
Arm strength is a nice thing to have when the window of opportunity is very small. Quarterbacks with strong arms can still fire it in there. Nice throw right on target by the QB.
The kick is good. They put up three here in the first to take the lead.
It's always good to get those points on the board and get the lead and get the other team chasing you.
The same as a touchback as he's tackled right at the 20. The Lions heading back out there on offense, hoping to improve on their last possession, which ended rather quickly with a punt.
Yeah, I think what they got to do, they got to come out and be a little more creative, get the defense off guard, make them think over there. That was too generic what they did on the offensive side. If you want to score, show some ingenuity.
First down at the 20. And it's batted down.
Johnson's one of those guys. If he drops a pass or makes a mistake on the field, he doesn't make excuses. He knows no matter what the circumstances are, if you get your hands on the football as a receiver in the NFL, everybody expects you to make the catch.
Looking long. On target. That's his first reception today.
Always love it when all the experts say arm strength is overrated in the NFL. Well, tell me about that after that throw and catch.
Let's see what they do on first down following that huge play. Johnson's got it and a first.
Well, the quarterback has such great confidence in the receiver. And why not? He's talented, and every time the football's thrown his way, he finds a way to make the catch.
McCoy's got two tight ends on the field for this snap. Could have been intercepted. Coming to the line at the 34. The Lions line up, split backfield. Second and 10. Almost intercepted that time.
You know, Jim, it's been a long time, but when I played and it was third and long early in the game, I knew the defense was going to be very careful. So I was already thinking, if I don't like it down the field, I'm going to throw it short and do it quickly.
Following that incompletion, it sets up third and 10. The Browns defense brings in an extra member of the secondary. They'll go nickel. McCoy's back in shotgun formation. It's intercepted. They bring him to the turf. Midway through the first quarter, and it's always a time where you're punching and counterpunching, and now they've got the pick and a chance to even score again.
Now, what would you know about punching and counterpunching, Jim? Were you a boxer at one time? It's amazing. You've done every sport, but you're right. They went out there. They did everything right. They've done everything right on both sides of the ball, and they're looking good.
My goodness, what a hit, and the ball falls incomplete. And the offense here in this one will be looking to put points on the board in bunches. Failing to complete that one, so second down here. The Browns at the line of scrimmage. Split backfield. Glennon's got it in the gun. Glennon's off the mark there. Incomplete. And here's a look at the defensive unit that'll be looking to halt this offense today. The offense now needs to pick up the first here on third down after that incompletion. The Browns line up. First down marker right at the 47-yard line. From the shotgun. The Browns now move the chains.
The Browns on their offensive play sheet, they don't have many plays for third and long situations, but that is a really nice job that time by the offense, the quarterback. They pick up the first down. That'll get you going.
First and 10. He'll throw it over the middle. Pass his target.
The Browns did a good job there on first down. That pass picks up some good solid yards. Now second and short. Much easier to call those kind of plays.
After the catch, it's now second down and one. Mike Glennon takes a look down from under center. Bell's handed the football. In the end, it picks up only a yard.
Bell's a very smart runner. He knows situations in the game. He saw the first down yard markers, and what does he do? He gets past them and picks up the first down.
First down and 10. Bell's going to secure the handoff.
Got to give the defense some credit. On first down, there's so many things the offense can do. They were ready for that play, and they stopped it.
Loss of two on that play. The Browns take it from the 43. He's got the catch. Not able to get away from Tulloch that time.
Good job that time by the quarterback. Looks down the field. Nobody open, so he throws the drag route. Coming across the field, and it's a nice catch. Just short of the first down.
Set up now at the 32. Third and short. Bell's going to take the handoff now.
Bell's trying to find a way to pick up that short yardage situation on third down, but the defense does an outstanding job, especially the defensive line. Nowhere to run and no first down.
It'll be a touchback. The Lions' offense can reignite things now after last time moving the football only to throw a drive-ending interception.
And this is what this defense lives on. They thrive on it. They let you move the football a little bit, but they wait for that mistake. Is that mistake going to be an offensive penalty, a drop pass? That time it was an interception, so that's what this defense does, and they do it well.
This should be the last play of the quarter. McCoy's going to take it from the gun. Brings it in. That's a gain of six. We're now about to begin quarter number two. And how much pressure do you think these offenses are feeling right now to open this game up, partner?
Jim, I'm going to go back to when I played. The longer you go in a game without having success, I think it makes you tighter and you lose confidence on the offensive side. So they need something here to get them off to a quick start and get them feeling good. There's no doubt time of possession can be an overrated stat in games many times. But one thing you want to do, throw and catch it just like this to pick up those first downs and keep it going.
McCoy is completion percentage, 50% on the day. Look at Mingo take him to the ground.
When you talk about a blitz on the defensive side, it's all about timing. Disguise it to the last second and time up the snap of the football. They did it that time, and they get the sack on the QB. When it's third and long on the offensive side, you have very few choices on how to pick up a first down. Call one of them and see if you get lucky and see if it works.
Third down on the way. The Lions are at the line of scrimmage with a pair of backs split behind the quarterback. And it's incomplete. Just couldn't hold on to it after the hit.
Just into the second quarter, and the pressure now on the defense to get the ball back.
Yes, you'd like for the defense to get off the field, not give up any points. But so far, the offense, man, they have been absolutely awful. They got to get their act together over there on the sideline.
Gilbert's going to take this one from the 26. Tucker going to make the tackle and a run back of about 8. The Browns offense will try to buck the trend here, as now we'll see if the punting units can stay on the sideline for a little while, because defense has been the order of the day here, Phil.
Well, Jim, listen, this has been kind of refreshing. I love it that the defenses are dominating. I'm sick of all these rules on the offensive side. So defenses, take advantage of this and keep on rocking. Got to give a lot of credit to the defense. They were all over the run that time, and they only give up a short gain.
Second down following the run. The Browns come out with a split backfield. Glennon standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. And this goes incomplete as he was looking over the middle.
Quarterbacks love to see a receiver have this type of play. Even though he doesn't make the catch, the effort is outstanding, and he's given everything he has to make that catch.
The Lions defense now is going to go nickel. The Browns from the 37. Locked in on the football and has hold of it with two hands.
I don't know what the answer is when it comes to guarding these tight ends now. There's just not much you can do. I'll tell you the best way to stop the tight end, rush the quarterback.
First and 10.
When you're going against a good quarterback and receiver in the NFL now, one of the ways to stop it is tight man-to-man coverage. You against him.
It's Glennon out of the pistol. Second down and 10. Bell's got it on the handoff. And that'll be a gain of about 2.
Bell's a dangerous runner when you give him room to run, but there is no room this time. What a job by the defense. They bottle him up for a short gain.
It's third down coming up. Glennon's going to take the snap from the shotgun. Middle of the field and incomplete this time.
On the offensive side, when it's third long, all you want to prevent is the turnover. You did that, so it's a victory for the offense.
This punt will not be returned. It will never see the field of play as it sails out of bounds. The Lions are experiencing a little bit of a drought here offensively, having gone 3 straight possessions without a score. What do you think needs to be done to buck that trend here, partner?
I'd say it's a little more than a drought. This is some awful offense, and there's many things you've got to do. You've got to tell your offensive line to pick things up. When the offensive line is aggressive, it gives all the stars a chance to succeed, and that's what they got to do here. Offensive line, get it going.
Finds his mark.
The Lions have been awesome today on first down. That time, it's a nice play design. They throw the football, picks up solid yards. Second and short. Boy, that's what every offense likes to be in.
McCoy's completion percentage, 50% on the day. The Lions have it at the 39. Brought down at the 47-yard line.
If you're running back and you want more carries, do things like this. Read the defense right, read the blocking, and pick up first downs. That's a really good job by the running back.
Two tight ends on the field here. draw play here. Tackle right around midfield.
If you want to run the football with success, you're going to have plays like this where they pick up very little yardage. Don't listen to the fans. Keep running it, and it'll work.
Let's go. Blue landed. Watch it now, Barney. Barney. Here we go.
The play clock's running down. Going for the home run. Comes down with, oh, the defender tips it out.
Sometimes when you have a player with this kind of talent, you're willing to put up with a few drop passes because when he catches it, he has a chance of going all the way.
Third down and six. They'll go ground. And he's going to be tackled, and that's going to bring us to fourth down. Midway through the second quarter, and the defense gets the ball back to the offense, looking to extend the lead.
Well, they got it rolling here as a football team. The defense did its job. Now can the offense, like you said, go out there and extend the lead, string some good plays together, and put this other team in a tough situation.
Gilbert's got it on the return. He's brought down at the 20-yard line. And a run back of about six. The Lions defense, Phil, where are they right now mentally after the last time giving up a couple of first downs, but in the end forcing the punts?
They feel great. And I'll give a lot of credit to the coaches on the sideline. I thought they put the players in good positions, and the players took advantage of it.
Hand off. Breaks free. And the tackle.
You're running back in this league, and you pick up first downs, and you don't fumble the football. I promise you one thing, you're going to get more carries.
The Browns come out in the pistol. Now first and 10. Here's the handoff. Running room. Gains 16.
Johnson's a great running back to have on your football team, isn't he? He goes up in there and gets the first down. Now your offense has three more chances.
First and 10. Touchdown, Cleveland Browns.
Nice catch by the rookie wide receiver, and how about that? His first receiving touchdown in the NFL. He is so talented, there is no doubt he's going to have a lot more.
The Lions are ready to receive the kick. Tate's got it on the return. There's a flag right there.
Illegal block in the back. Return team.
It's an illegal block in the back, and the coaching staff cannot be happy about this.
No, it's a bad decision, and most of all, it's dangerous. You can hurt players when you block them like that.
Let's go.
First down at the 17. He has the grab. Brought down at the 26.
Lions coaching staff, they have been smart today. They are keeping everybody off balance, even me. I thought for sure they would run the football, but no, they come out on first down, they throw it, they pick up solid yards. Good job by them.
McCoy's completion percentage, 50% on the day.
339.
And we've reached the two-minute warning. First half winding down as we return from the two-minute warning. For this play, they'll go with two tight ends. They'll run it here. He's tackled beyond the markers. It's a first down. The running attack has been stopped, and that's a big reason why they are behind. They will have to turn around the ground attack, Phil, to get back into this game.
I think you're right. They are getting dominated, Jim Nance, getting run over. The offensive line has got to make a stand. And you know what? The running back, it's not against the rules. You're allowed to break a tackle.
The defender able to knock it away.
So many times when you drop a football in the NFL, a pass like that, It's because of lack of concentration. You're just not serious about what you're doing.
Second and 10. Johnson's got it. First down. The Lions signal for the timeout. And that's the first one they've used. They're back at the line after that catch for a first down. McCoy's back in shotgun formation. And it's swatted away. The Browns sat at the line. Dime package. Second down and 10. Long ball to Calvin Johnson. What a catch. That's reception number 4 for him. The Lions have tried to lean on the passing attack so far. Johnson's been a favorite of his quarterback, and he's proven why he deserves to be targeted so often today.
You're right. He deserves to be targeted because he is one of the better wide receivers in the NFL. And when he catches it, look out, he can get yards after the catch.
McCoy is unable to connect that time.
That incompletion by the quarterback, hey, I give the quarterback no fault. That was just tremendous coverage by the secondary player. He's in position and able to make the football be incomplete.
To Ebron. Ebron's tackled down after a gain of 7. The Lions call a timeout and are left now with only 1. That timeout might be very useful for the offense. They're now ready to go. This will be the 8th play of this drive.
Let's go! 319! 319!
The Browns with a nickel look here on defense. Gets the handle here. The tackle's made and the first down is picked up. The offense stops the clock right away with a timeout. Of scrimmage is the 16. An extra tight end on the field for this one. And it's batted down.
Gets tight down here in the red zone. So if you're a defender, read the quarterback. If you make a quick break on the football, hey, you'll get in position like this and you can knock it down.
McCoy's setting up now in the pistol. Second and 10. And it's knocked down.
Things get tight down here in the red area. I got to give the defensive man a lot of credit, though. In position, sees the ball thrown, and is able to get that hand up there and knock it down.
All right, here we go. Green 39. Green 39. Lucky 56.
The Browns with 2 extra defensive backs in the dime. Third down and 10. Hayden nearly comes away with the pick on that pass.
It's a nice play that time by the defense. The offense is inside your red zone. You got to stop them from scoring. That was a good job of swatting the football away.
Drives it through for the field goal. And that should put them a little more at ease come halftime.
Yeah, I think it will. I think it gave them a confidence boost, and they gained confidence. On the other side, I think they lost confidence because of that field goal.
Gilbert's got a chance for a return. And he's tackled right at about the 28-yard line. The Browns now ready to take over again on offense. They were successful on their previous drive, getting the ball all the way to the end zone. I'm sure they're looking for more of the same right now.
Oh, absolutely. That's what you always want. You want to find your way to the end zone. And so many people contributed on that last drive, and you've got to give the coaches a lot of credit for putting the players in excellent position. Bell's trying to be patient, but there is nowhere to run that time, and he only gets a short gain.
That'll do it for the first half. We'll be sending you to Larry Ridley back in our studios as we continue with the NFL on EA Sports.
Thanks, Jim. I'm Larry Ridley, and welcome to the EA Sports Halftime Report. The Lions are on the bad end of things at home, but we'll have two quarters to turn it around. The Browns deserve to be ahead, but we'll need to put together another strong half.
The second half is officially underway. Wilson's going to start his return. Barrels ahead. Wilson's tackle right at the 28. And a run back of about 20. The Browns come out to open up the second half, and they were hitting on all cylinders in the first half, Phil.
Yeah, be smart here in the second half, Jim. When you start out, just find out what the defense is thinking. And once you get a feeling about what they're going to do, then you start taking some chances.
He's averaging 5 yards per carry on the day.
Bell's never able to build up that power that he has as a running back when there's nowhere to go. Hey, there is nowhere to go. That's a short game.
The Browns will take the snap from the 30. Bell's taking the handoff. And there's only 2 yards to be found right there.
Holding offense.
The defense will take the penalty.
Still second down.
And now, after the penalty, it's second down and 15. The Browns line up, split backfield. Glennon's got it in the gun. He's wide open for the grab. All the way home and all alone. Touchdown. That touchdown early in the third quarter certainly gives them full command of this game, Phil.
Well, let me coach up the defense here, little Jim. What you did in that drive was just not good enough. Change your strategy. Be more aggressive. You're down in the game. We're in the second half. Now it's time to make things happen.
Are getting their offense geared up here. It's going to be interesting to see, Phil, how they react, because I know there was a letdown the last time they had it. They kept the ball for a long time. They picked up a whole ton of yardage, but ended up with only a field goal. So let's see how they'll react now.
Jim, I think you're right. I think they were disappointed in the fact that they executed so many plays and ended up with a field goal. Let's see if they can come out and look for something a little more dynamic where they don't have to have those long drives. Look for big plays instead. Browns guessed right on the defensive side that time. They thought it was going to be a run play. They were all over it, and they got it in the backfield and made the tackle.
Loss of 3 on the play. Double tight end formation. Second down and 13. Takes it from the eye. And that's a 2-yard gain. He's averaged about 2 yards a carry on the day.
This is a tough situation to be in. It's third and long, and I'll say this to the coach and the quarterback. Don't take a chance. If it's covered down the field, throw it short.
Takes it from the gun. Look at that concentration as he makes the grab.
Well, don't look at the scoreboards, which tells you you're down by a couple scores. Just concentrate on every single play and try to get another first down.
The Lions at the line of scrimmage. Split backfield. McCoy's going to take it from the gun. Second and 10 coming up. The Lions from the 27. And he's taken down.
Well, I know this feeling. When a blitzer's coming, nobody's there to block him. There's nothing you can do as a quarterback, but try to protect yourself because you're going down.
On the way, third down. Got a flag. And it's swatted away.
Holding offense. The penalty is declined.
John Ryan will be called on to send this one down the field. No chance to return this one as that punt is headed to the sidelines. A look at Glover Quinn right there. And it's been a long day for this unit, and any hopes they had of turning things around at halftime haven't come to fruition.
Yeah, listen, I don't know what they did at halftime, but whatever they did, it didn't work. They just got to pick up the pace. You got to have some pride on the defensive side. That's what they need right now.
And that's a gain of maybe five. He's averaging 5 yards per carry on the day.
Nice run that time. When you run the football like this, over a period of time, it's going to wear that defense out. There's no doubt about it. Nice job by the offensive line.
Second down, 4 to go. Gordon's got it. Going to take it the distance. In stride, and he's home for the touchdown. At this point in the game, midway through the third, that touchdown has them on the brink of putting this game away.
Man, they're starting to put their mark on this game, Jim, and you just got to be careful. Don't let it get away from you right here. Find a way to go out there and score on the offensive side and get back into this football game.
The Lions now have even more work to do to get back into this one. Scores 24-3. Tate's going to test the coverage here. And they stop him from running it out to the 20. Mark him down at the 19. The Lions at this point are just trying to stop the bleeding as they come out for this drive, Phil.
Whoa, I don't know if there's enough band-aids to stop all this bleeding. But look, you're looking for a moral victory, so the game is not over. Try to get some good here late to make you feel better and get ready for the next game.
The Browns lined up in the nickel. First down at the 19. And he's forced to the ground.
The offensive line that time had no idea this cornerback was coming on the blitz. He timed it perfectly, and the speed and the talent to get there, and he gets the sack on the QB.
Loss of 5 on the play. Second and long. Ebron's got it on a pass that had some heat.
Nice job that time, but the tight end makes the catch, and you got to look out for him now in the NFL. Remember, they're usually the closest receiver to the quarterback. Quarterback gets in trouble, he's going to look for the tight end.
They bring in the extra tight end. Third and 2. We'll go draw. Finally, a third down conversion.
On its third and short, the defensive line, you got to guess. You got to think it's going to be a run play. I don't know what they were thinking. They let the offense just push them back, and they give up the first down. Good job by the offense, though.
The Browns defense now loading up, expecting pass with a dime defense. And Calvin Johnson can't hold on that time.
Well, sometimes when you have a talented receiver, you just got to put up with plays like that. He might drop a few, but when he does catch it, it can make a big play.
The Browns defense brings in an extra member of the secondary. They'll go nickel. Heaving it down the field. Incomplete.
Third long situations. A lot of coordinators in this league will run a draw play on third long. Why? Because they're just looking for field position, pick up a few yards, and then by some miracle, if the running back's able to make guys miss, break some tackles, and pick up a first down, man, that's just gravy.
The Lions are at the line of scrimmage with a pair of backs split behind the quarterback. And it's batted down.
The Lions really don't have much of a chance of picking up this first down. It's third and long. Of course, the defense is looking for passes down the field. They're all over everything, and the pass goes incomplete.
Gilbert's going to take this one from the 22. That return's good for about six. The Browns had to deal with adversity early, Phil. Bell's been a key component as he's chipped away at that defense and now finding room to work.
Jim, it's like a boxing match. You got to throw some body blows early in the fight to soften them up. They did that. They softened that defense up. Now they're taking advantage of it.
Looking middle that time, and it's incomplete. Bell lined up as the single back. The Browns from the 27. And that pass is just thrown away.
Third long coming up. You're losing by a couple scores. You're on the defensive side. You must know the offense is not going to take a chance. So be aggressive and maybe get lucky and get a turnover.
Now looking at third down. Glennon standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. Pulls it in. He's in the clear. The 20. The 10. Touchdown. This game is really out of hand now. Still just the third quarter, but I think we're close to being able to put this one in the books.
Oh, yeah. Get that OW column and put a slash underneath it because they have won the game, and they deserve to win, Jim, with their enthusiasm, the emotion they have shown, and playing such solid football.
He's got a chance to return this one. Keeps his legs moving, and he's tackled right at the 30-yard line after that return. The Browns have gotten a huge lift from their defense all game long here, and now well into the second half as well.
It always starts with defensive line play, just like an offensive line. When the defensive line plays well, that helps the linebackers and all the defensive backs.
All right, here we go.
First down at the 30. Ebron's got it on a pass, had some heat on it. The Lions get a first down.
Well, that'll make you feel a little better, finally getting a first down. You're down big in the second half, and you're on the offensive side. Don't look for the quick score. Just look to pick up positive yards and hope it leads you to a score later.
First down here after the completion. McCoy's going to take the snap from the shotgun. And it's knocked down.
Lots of ways to attack cover two. There's no doubt about it. You can throw it underneath. You can pump fake the safeties, make one of them move, and still throw it deep down the field.
Second down after the incompletion.
Here we go now. Green 39. Green 39.
On the money. Brought down at the 44.
Well, we see it more and more. Football's thrown behind the line of scrimmage. They do it that time. Nice catch, but a loss of yards on the play.
The Browns will come out in the dime.
Now let's go. Green.
The Lions have it at the 44. Ebron's going to pull in the bullet pass. And they advance the ball onto the other side of the field.
All you can do is your job. And that was a good job by the offense, picking up the first down. You're down big in the second half. Hey, don't worry about the score right now. Just find ways to execute plays and get down there and score a touchdown.
The offense is set at the line for the first down after that completion. Ebron's there to catch a ball that had a lot of heat on it.
When you get aggressive safeties, you like to get up there and try to stop the run. The post route is an awesome way to take advantage of that. Go down the field 10 to 12 yards, plant that outside foot, run towards the goalpost. Nice throw by the quarterback.
We head to the fourth quarter, and both of these teams are looking to just stay healthy. And my man, Phil Sims, is looking for a way to escape early to the airport. We've got a blowout. We're back after this. The final quarter underway now with this snap. Should have had it, but the hit knocked it out.
Well, they always say if you get your hands on the football, you got to make the catch. Yeah, right. The guy that made that rule up wasn't getting hit as he was trying to catch the football. Nice hit that time by the defender.
The Browns come out in a dime package. The Lions take it from the 23. Johnson's got the catch and the first. That's 5 receptions on the day.
Well, you're really in a tough spot, but that is a good job picking up the first down. You're down big in the second half. All you can do, just keep picking up those first downs. You hope it leads you to a score, and then you play the game from there. Anytime your team is down, you're inside the other team's red zone, you look for one of your star players, your quarterback, wide receiver, or running back. They need to make a big play here.
Two hands on the football and has the catch.
Just keep playing the game. You're down here near the goal line. You're getting blown out, but keep playing hard. You never know. Next week, you might be in the same situation, and you can draw on this positive reinforcement maybe you get from this next play.
McCoy is completion percentage. 50% on the day. Goal line defense on the field. Will go ground. Short run, and it's a touchdown.
In the old days, if you're a quarterback, it was rare to get a pass near the goal line. Nowadays, it's rare for the running back to get a run near the goal line. And the big guy took advantage of it this time. He gets the run near the goal line, and he takes it in for the TD.
He made it. The Browns are back deep, ready to return. Gilbert's running this one out. Just across the 20 and tackled at the 21. As we see the stats now, you really like what both guys have been able to do at wideout today, Phil.
Yeah, they have been spectacular out there on the field. The numbers are awesome. This league, once again, we know it's about to pass, and we saw it here today.
Bell is in the backfield. First down at the 21. Bell up the middle. He's averaging 5 yards per carry on the day.
Bell is a dangerous runner when you give him room to run, but there is no room this time. What a job by the defense. They bottle him up for a short gain.
The Browns snap it at the 26. Johnson's tackled down at the 32.
I think the coach on the sidelines, he's going to be happy with every first down because he knows that's more time off the clock. When you're up like this, multiple scores in the second half, every first down just puts the odds in your favor of winning this game.
The Browns from the 32. Handoff made. Picked up a couple that time.
Johnson's trying to be patient, but there is nowhere to run that time, and he only gets a short gain.
It's now second down and 7 after the 3-yard rush. It's Glennon out of the pistol. Right back to him. Trying to power his way right up the middle.
Johnson's never able to build up that power that he has as a running back when there's nowhere to go. Hey, there's nowhere to go. That's a short game.
Third down following the run. Bell's handed the football. Keeps his legs moving.
This offense can't be stopped on third down, no matter the distance.
What a good job by the running back that time. He reads the blocks very well, and he picks his way through there and picks up a first down. That's nice.
First down here after the run. It's a two tight end formation. Back to the ground. That's a gain of 7. He's averaging 5 yards per carry on the day.
Always good to have these types of runs. Yeah, it's not a first down, but it sends a message. It shows everybody that you can run it when you want to. And also, it opens up so many other things for your offense.
Johnson's lined up behind his quarterback as the single back. And Gaze all over the ball carrier.
Brown's running back that time. He makes a bad decision. You can't be looking to make every play a big play when you're running the football. Look for a few yards. Take advantage of that. He tries for the big play. What happens? He gets tackled for a loss.
Throws the pass. A nice grab. No doubt he was going to hold on to that one. That's his first reception today. The Browns are in front thanks to their quarterback. Glennon's had a huge performance in this one.
When you talk about creating opportunities, that's where you have to give credit to the coaching staff. They have helped the players. The play designs have been good, and the players are taking advantage of it.
The Lions go with the dime formation here on defense. First down at the 34.
Bell up the middle.
He's taken down at the 23. The Browns have had a great rushing attack all game, Phil. Bell's been a consistent force on the ground.
Yeah, he's just a running back who never gives up. And when he runs, it's arms, elbows, everything is moving, and he is one tough running back to tackle.
First down and 10. Gaines about 3.
Well, not many yards to get there on that play, but it doesn't matter. What a day and what a job this running back has done here.
2 minutes remaining, and you're watching the NFL on EA Sports. We're back. Only 2 minutes remain in this one. Second down and 7. He'll get it again. And that'll gain just a few yards. He's averaging about 4 yards a carry.
Johnson's a dangerous runner when you give him room to run, but there is no room this time. What a job by the defense. They bottle him up for a short game.
What a drive this has been. It's an empty backfield for Glennon this time. Drop back, shotgun formation. Reaches out and grabs it. Tackle's made, and the first down is picked up.
First down by the offense in the red zone. And, you know, if you're on the defensive side, you don't have to worry about deep passes anymore. You can be more aggressive and take some chances.
They're back at the line after that catch for a first down. Glennon's back in shotgun formation. The blowout continues. Another touchdown. Impressive showing today, and it's almost on the brink of running up the score and creating some bad blood. What do you think, Phil?
Who cares, man? Rub it in, baby. Rub it in. When you're on top and you're winning the game, I say go for it. Rub some salt in that wound and let them know how much it hurts.
Catches it at the 2 and starts his return. It out to about the 27 before he's taken down. The Lions come out now with little time left on the clock, and they've got to be thinking, what could have been here today, partner?
Yeah, that's it. You know, Jim, these are tough moments, and what you do in a situation like this, don't throw any more gasoline on the fire. If you're the quarterback, don't take a chance and throw a silly interception that people are going to talk about. Don't fumble the ball if you get the ball in your hands as a runner or a receiver, and just get this game over with. Well, that'll make you feel a little better, finally getting a first down. You're down big in the second half, and you're on the offensive side. Don't look for the quick score. Just look to pick up positive yards and hope it leads you to a score later.
And this will probably wrap things up here.
You come into week one trying to build some positive momentum. You've gone through camp and all the preseason games, and now you walk away 0-1. How do you handle it?
Well, it's hard. You got to handle it because you just say to yourself, it's a long year. We'll correct the mistakes we made today, and we'll be better, and we'll win next week to make us 1-1.
For Phil Simms and